We said, we got to disrupt this way of thinking. If nobody else could figure it out, at the time there was about 120 breweries in BC, 150 here in Ontario. Calgary had two, Big Rock and Wild Rose, 12 province-wide. So we said, how about this? Can we be an importer? They said, no problem. We can import beer. We got our license to import beer, took all that beautiful barley, shipped it out of the province to British Columbia, drove 12 hours out to a brewery out in BC, out in Vancouver, brewed our beer there, drove back home across the border, and imported our own beer back into the city. Insane, right? It was ridiculous, but it took a year of and 600,000 kilometers on my nice Toyota Tacoma, but driving out to brew, driving back, driving out. But all the while, when I was back in Calgary, going to the media, talking to, you know, people in the street, telling them, we're not just trying to get our friends drunk with this brewery. I mean, we are, but also, what this represents is economic development in this province and in this country. What barley contributes to in this world is unbelievable. And so for us to say, look how many jobs are created in this industry. Every dollar you spend on local craft beer contributes $1.12 to the economy. We had all these great reports. It just didn't work for the government to listen to us. So we went to the media, went to the CBC, I went to CTV News. I went, I learned about social media, went to newspapers, and I started singing and yelling and screaming about this beautiful province around us, these prairie farms, this barley. And what happened was people started to see this authentic and genuine passion for something much bigger than just my company. It was a collaborative approach to saying, it's the whole industry that needs to grow. And a year of doing that, we finally, December 2013, the AGLC in Alberta relented and said, no more minimum brewing requirement. Congratulations, Tool Shed, they said. So we get to brew. No, thank you, that's amazing, I appreciate that. The neat thing is, now there's 100 breweries in the province, they're all hiring locals, and you know, it's a great thing to have accomplished, not even close to getting past the hurdles. Now we get a building, right? Because now we've got the laws changed, should be easy. Go to the bank, get a couple million bucks, right? Is there any bankers in the room I should ask before we go on to the next stage? It's about to get dark in here. Yeah, no, I won't say what bank, but we went to our bank that we had been with since we were kids, and they laughed in our faces. Because who the hell am I, right? I'm some random IT idiot running around homebrewing and saying we're gonna make this great brewery. So of course banks don't believe that you're gonna pull it off. This cash flow crunch, I think, hits pretty much any business that gets going. So okay, screw the banks. The meeting that we went to, the first meeting with my bank, they said, a brewery? Well, that's adorable. They used the word adorable. That's like, run along, you little rascals. A brewery, shaking their hair, go on, all right? So, okay, screw the banks, we'll go to investors, because I watched Dragon's Den, right? Investors believe in the person, not just the business plan, right? No, that's all BS, too. The investors say, have you done this before? No, I haven't. I've lived in Afghanistan for 5 years, so no money for you. What Tool Shed is still to this day is 10 good friends and family members that believed in us. That's the burden of what all in actually means when you go after a dream and you go after a business. I've got people, my buddy Chuck the firefighter, who I said no at first, because you're not supposed to mix friends and money, right? Well, Chuck the firefighter says, man, I got $50,000 to my name, but I'm getting married this month, so I can only give you 40. Yeah. Right? And I'm his best man. I can't get up on the stage and say, all right, congratulations, guys, you're married, and then go take his life savings. But I did. Yeah, that's what we are, and the reason that that's so important is that it's such a burden of responsibility, but it really shows you what is all in. That's the kind of all in that gets you into your bed at night at 3 a.m. sobbing, bawling at 3 a.m. because you don't want to ruin the people's lives around you. We are 10 people. All in for poker is a joke. All in for me is a joke. I'm of course I'm all in. It's my business. But when you're all in with everyone you love around you, with their all in, that's 3 a.m. crying in your bed at night.